Hey guys, welcome back. Cheesy mushroom omelette. Such a quick and tasty start to the day. You just can't go wrong. Absolutely delicious with all those umami flavors. I usually cook the mushrooms in a garlic infused olive oil, which makes it even more tasty. But if you even use a regular cooking oil, it will still turn out incredibly delicious. So let's get cooking.
We start off the cooking of the omelette by first chopping up a clove of garlic. Make sure the garlic is very finely chopped. You don't want large pieces to come through. You can even use minced garlic if you have in a freezer, perfectly okay. Once the garlic is done, then we move on to the mushrooms. I'm just using normal button mushrooms. You can use any mushrooms of your choice or whatever mushroom that you can get would work well. But make sure that the mushrooms are sliced very evenly. The finer they're sliced, the better it is. It'll cook evenly and it'll cook faster. I like to use just 2 eggs for my omelette. If you like 3, feel free, add 3. The choice is absolutely yours. This is a mushroom and a cheese omelette, so it has a lot of flavor to it. It has a lot of umami to it, and it works extremely well. You have to whisk your eggs well so that the egg white and the egg yolks really break down together and you get a nice yellow kind of a batter consistency. If you leave the whites not really whipped up, you get the white strands into your omelette, and that does not look nice. We begin by first lightly sauteing the garlic in little oil. Now you can use butter if you like, that again a personal preference. I like to keep it light because I do have a lot of cheese going in, so I go easy on the fats and use a vegetable oil. Lightly saute the garlic and add in the sliced mushroom and just toss it together. Just gently sweat them together to let the garlic infuse in the oil and the mushroom cook in the garlic flavored oil. Some cracked black pepper and salt. There is something about black pepper and salt with omelettes. It is a magical combination. It really works well. Once the mushrooms have softened up, I will transfer that into a bowl for it to slightly cool down. This is going to go as a filling inside the omelette. Now, a lot of people actually cook the eggs in the mushrooms. Even that is perfectly okay. I like it to go inside so it is visual. To make the omelette, a little oil in the pan. Now again, if you like butter, add butter. It's your choice. Add the whisked eggs. Now if you remember, I've put no salt on it. If you add salt earlier, the eggs become very runny. Always add the salt at this stage when your eggs begin to cook in the pan. And because there is a low heat in the pan, the bottom and the sides begin to cook and change color. At this stage, you whisk your eggs together in the pan and form the layers or the skins of the egg. Bring the egg together. But don't make it into a scrambled egg. Once the egg coagulates and becomes a bit firm, add in the mushrooms and the garlic mixture on top of the omelette on one side and spread out very evenly, and then sprinkle in the cheese. It's a very simple way of making an omelette. But a lot of people try and do a folded omelette, which is really oval shape. It has got cheese and mushroom inside. I like my omelettes to be slightly open, so it's visual. Again, it's a personal preference. If you like it to be totally concealed, fold the omelette over the mushrooms and you can have a half moon shape or you can have an olive shape. With a spatula, loosen up the eggs from the bottom and the edges, which helps you to fold over the eggs very easily. Now also, I do not like my eggs to be just about pale yellow. I like my eggs well done. Again, like I say, it is a personal choice. This is the way I like to have my eggs. If you like to have slightly undercooked, that's perfectly okay. So here you have it, my mushroom and cheese omelette. I should say rather a mushroom and an open cheese omelette. Bon appetit, enjoy, and leave your comments on the section below. Happy cooking!